I want to clarify something that I said in my previous video about how narcissists will point out to you the parts of your belief system that are not working for you and where you have misplaced your reverence. And I realize, I always realize, in fact, a very similar thing belatedly, because there are two steps to this process of realizing. One is that I can invent a theoretical construct which analyzes my experiences and analyzes what I've gained from them. And then the other part is to realize, too, that the reason why I've had those experiences has been because of my very distinct and unique historical position in the world. And when I say that, I'm not bragging. It's not a feather in my cap. That would be looking at it in a way that's non-historical, but purely based on the common and prevalent perspective that is adopted now and used restrictedly within modernity. So my experience is just a historical fact. It happens to be different. It happens to be unique. And I have had that that different experience of narcissists and what they can do, because they have revealed to me something quite specific, I guess, in the ultimate analysis about modernity, which is that the attitudinal stance of people is based on the presupposition that everybody is an actor, that we're all acting a role and acting out to gain a benefit, and that none of it is really real in a deep sense. Now, why that has to be an additional stated fact is that my common experience with a narcissist is that they point me back to my roots, to my African roots, to my Rhodesian roots, and point out that really those have defined me and will continue to do so despite any efforts I might make to change that. So that's why it's an additional important point, because the jarring effect that very acting-oriented types have on me is probably more extreme than they would have on people who were brought up in modernity and were consequently more accustomed to the normalization of acting and acting out. Why 2 points. Why I said that is to clarify how I think I personally have gained through exposure to narcissistic types. They point me back to myself. They point me back to what I'm really thinking, which is that I don't want to be an acting type. I don't want to be, in that sense, a narcissistic type. And I don't belong there. And they always point me back to that. And the other point is that just as a matter of good chance, I was reading a section from Nietzsche's The Gay Science. And he points out that in history, there have been cultures that have been oriented toward building an edifice of culture, and other cultures that are oriented toward acting. And acting means that you know that you're expressing a persona, and that that persona is really the most deterministic factor in your life, and you're happy with that. And Nietzsche said that he has another opposition. He comes up with quite a few of these binaries, in a way, not really binaries, but oppositional kind of dynamics. He points out a difference between Rome, which had an intention to build a culture that would last maybe 1,000 years, and Greece, where people took on a role and then began to understand that they had taken on a mask, taken on a role, and then adapted themselves to that knowledge and became happy with just being that role or just being that mask. And he said that that acting spirit conquered Rome. He said, not Greek culture, the acting spirit of Greece. And he said that in the 19th century, it was doing it again. Everybody was basically just an actor. And I think that has also been true for us in our 20th and 21st centuries. And maybe we're just coming to our senses in a way, in understanding what that means. So this the sense that people are not trying to be or needing to be deeply authentic or needing to be part of a structure of civilization, because that's the opposition he frames, the actor versus the stone in the edifice of a very structured and planned and designed culture. In that sense that it's okay to be an actor nowadays, and that that is the normal thing. This is what I'm at odds with in terms of my own psyche, because again and again, this taking on the role of being an actor and being happy with others being an actor has brought me deep dissatisfaction and alarm, and I find it most disturbing. I'm an edifice sort of person. I'm not an actor. I am what I am. and so. But it has led me into all sorts of trouble, because the minute I forget who I am, I forget, well, I'm a stone in an edifice sort of person. And that's what I need to be. That's what I want to be. And then I forget that. And I, because I've never really, you know, I never used to understand it so well until the narcissist brought me home to myself. And then I did. But at the time when I thought, well, I could adapt to modernity. I could be somebody that acts a role. I've always been a very poor actor because my heart wasn't in it. And then that can be very dangerous, because it points out to other people that they are actually acting. And I think that that really can lead to a lot of strife. So those are my thoughts for the moment. I know it's very, very complicated. It's subtle, and it's historical, and it's theoretical, and it's psychological, and it has all these sorts of ramifications. I'll try and elaborate on it better next time. These are just hashing out my thoughts, and it's going to be very hot here today, and I'm wearing a coat because it looks better than the kimono I had on, but it's going to be very hot.